Now that we've added authentication and permissions to our user profile API, it's time to create a login API so users can log in to the system. We're going to start by opening up the Atom editor and navigating to our views.py file. The Django REST framework actually has a login API view that takes care of login for us. The only problem with this is that it's fixed as an API view and it doesn't have a view set option that we can use. This means that we can't use it with our standard router, default router that we have to set up our URLs. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the API view and we're going to trick the system to think that it's a view set. So the way that we do this is we start by importing the auth token serializer that comes with the Django REST framework and the obtain auth token API view. So up here in the imports, type from REST underscore framework dot auth token dot serializers import auth token serializer. And below that, let's import the obtain auth token API view. So type from REST underscore framework dot auth token dot views import obtain auth token. Okay, so now all we need to do is create a view set which passes the request through to this obtain auth token API view. And then we can have a view set for our login that we can use with our default router. So come down to the bottom here and let's add a new class called the login view set. So type class login view set and inherit from viewsets.viewset. We'll give it a doc string, checks email and password and returns an auth token. Okay, so we're going to set the serializer class to the auth token serializer, which we imported up here. So come back down to the bottom and type serializer underscore class equals auth token serializer. And next, we're going to define a create function. So create is what is called when you make a HTTP post to the view set. So type def create self request and give it the doc string, use the obtain auth token API view to validate and create a token. And now all we need to do is pass the request through to the obtain auth token API view and call the post function. So type return obtain auth token, and then we want to create a new object out of this class, so add the two brackets at the end and then put dot post to call the post function of the obtain auth token class, and we're going to pass in the parameter request. So it's simply going to do the same thing as it would if you were just calling the obtain auth token normally, but we're going to call it through our view set and we're going to return the response in the create function. Okay, so save the file. Next, we're going to add this view set to our URL router. So click on the urls.py file underneath the profiles API directory. And we're going to register a new router underneath the profile router. And we're going to call it login. So type router.register. And then add a string as the first parameter called login. And as the second parameter, we're going to tell it how to find our view set. So it's views dot, we want to call the login view set. And finally, we're going to set a base name equals login. And again, we need to set the base name because it's not a model view set. So there's no way for the Django REST framework to know what to call these objects or this router. Okay, so let's save that file. And that's how you create a login view set for your API. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.